Hi everyone! Welcome to this video on how to schedule tasks in a Syncfusion Blazor Gantt Chart component. In this video, I will show you how to schedule tasks based on the workweek, holidays, working time range, and task modes in the Gantt Chart. Let's dive right in. I am using an existing Blazor WebAssembly app. In this project, I have already configured a Gantt Chart with data. I have defined a class named TaskData with fields. The getTaskCollection method defines the data to the Gantt chart. To know how to bind data to the Gantt chart component, please watch the video which I have shared in the YouTube card. Now, I run the project. You can see the Gantt chart with task data bound to it. I can edit the taskbar. Let me show you how to schedule a workweek for this project. In the timeline, you can notice the default workweek is from Monday to Friday. Let me customize it from Sunday to Thursday. To do so, in the SF Gantt, add the workweek property and set a string collection. Set the starting day as Sunday and ends with Thursday. Setting this property will automatically consider the weekends as Friday and Saturday. Enable the highlight weekends property to differentiate the weekend days. Run the application. You can notice the weekend days, Friday and Saturday, were highlighted, and the working days are from Sunday to Thursday. You can also add the holidays to your project. To achieve it, in the SF Gantt, add the Gantt Holidays tag, and within it, you can add one or more holidays. Let me add a holiday for the date March 28th. This will consider for one day alone. Label it as a public holiday. Using the CSS class, you can customize the UI for the holidays. Let me add the style tag with the CSS class. Set the background and font weight. Add another holiday from April 6th to April 7th. This will add two continuous days as holidays. Set the label as public holidays. Run the application. You can see the holidays in the project. Next, let me show you how to schedule the working time range for the project. In the SF Gantt, add the Gantt Day Working Time collection. Within it, I can set one or more Gantt Day Working Time. Let me add one Gantt Day Working Time from 9 to 18 hours. Setting this working time will help to validate the task. Gantt tasks are validated based on the child tasks with some factors like working time, holidays, work weeks, that is weekends here in this project it is Friday and Saturday, and predecessors. The Gantt provides support for automatic, manual, and custom task scheduling modes. Task mode is used to indicate whether the start date and end date of all the tasks will be automatically validated or not. You can use the task mode property to change the schedule mode of a task. The default value is auto, let me set the same. Run the project. Here the validation is done automatically. To check this, let me change the 7th ID task from 3 to 4 days duration. You can notice the Gantt chart automatically considers the two public holidays and weekends and extends the timeline to the next working day, which is Sunday here. Next, let me change the task mode to manual. Run the application, you can notice that tasks are scheduled on weekends also. This means the start date and end date of all the tasks in the project will be the same as given in the data source. Also, you can notice a draggable bar is displayed at the top of the parent tasks indicating they are manually scheduled. Also, this means the tasks are not validated based on the factors such as dependencies between tasks, holidays, weekends, working time. Let me add a dependency from ID 2 to ID 3. It is a finish to start link, but you can notice the tasks are not validated and move the date respectively. You can restrict this mode in predecessor validation alone. That is, we can automatically validate the dates based on predecessor values by enabling the validate manual tasks on linking property. Let me do the same manual linking now. You can notice the task is moved to 2 days further, indicating the finish to start dependency. Next, let me show you how the custom task mode works. In the custom task mode, you can use auto and manual task modes as per the need of the task within the project. You need to map the manual scheduling tasks from the data source. First, let me set the task mode to custom. In the TaskData class, add a string property, isManual to indicate manual tasks to the Gantt chart. In the getTaskCollection method, in the task ID 2, set the isManual property to true, do the same for a few other tasks. To set this field to Gantt chart, in the Gantt task fields, set the manual property with the property name isManual. In the columns tag, add a new column to display the isManual field, so that you can see the task mode at the runtime. Run the application. You can see the task ID 3 task mode is set as manual, hence the end date is scheduled until Friday, which is a weekend in this project. validation is not done in this task. In the task ID 7, the task mode is set to auto. Even though the start date is April 1, which is a weekend for this project, the 3 days duration is scheduled after the weekend. Here the validation is done since its task mode is set as auto. If I edit the task to 4 days, the end time extends until the next working day. But when I edit a manual task, the dates are not validated. You can see both the auto and manual task modes are used in the custom mode. That's it. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the video description below. You can also check if you're eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key to use our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.